Okay, so who's going to practice with me, inshallah? Excellent, brother. Come down. Sorry, your name again? Abu Bakr, of course. Come and practice with me, Abu Bakr. I just want to hear why you think the Quran is from God. What are the convincing reasons you can give me? Some, try and convince me.
Do you agree with science, scientific facts mentioned in the Holy Quran? Do you believe in science, brother?
I do believe in science, yes.
Okay. If we ask the scientists, how yes. did our universe came into existence? They will tell us about the Big Bang theory.
Yes, that's
there was
right.
a primary nebula and there was a secondary separation after the Big Bang, you know. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it in 1400 years ago in the Quran. We came to know recently in 1925. It is discovered in 1925. The theory of Big Bang is propounded. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
says
said
that it, in the Quran, the Big Bang?
About the Big Bang in a nutshell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, chapter number 21, verse number 30, أَوَلَّمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَ تَرَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَهُمَا Do okay. not the unbelievers see that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clove them asunder. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the primary nebula. What scientists told us that the primary nebula is a composition of hot gaseous matter.
Mm.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told about the sky before its creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described this as a smoke. And this is the perfect description of the primary nebula. Mm. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned scientific facts about the expansion of universe, which we came to know in 1929 by Edwin Hubble. He discovered that the universe is continuously expanding. Distances between the galaxies and the stars continuously expanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Zariyat about it, that we have created the heaven and we will expand it. And always you know about the all scientific facts. If you
That's see. Really amazing. Isn't it possible though that, you know, maybe the ancient Babylonians and the ancient Egyptians and the Aztecs, you know, they had a lot of knowledge of astronomy. Even scientists find it very hard to explain how they could have built some of their buildings these days. So maybe they could have figured some of these things out and then Muhammad could have put it in the Quran.
No. If we
isn't that possible?
If we came to know with the historical background that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam living in a desert and he was illiterate person, how can it be possible that Babylonian and philosophers talks about the scientific facts? They have talked about it, they have believed in it, but they have wrong beliefs also. Oh. That they have believed that the sun is revolving yes. around the earth. And how can it be possible that an illiterate person in Arabia, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he collected only the right things from the place and collected in the
Excellent.
Quran.
Okay, good. Very good. Well done. Excellent. Does anyone want to try something different apart from science in the Quran? We don't want science now. No science, yeah? Come on then. Very good. Abu Bakr, that was excellent. MashaAllah. Quoting the verses, numbers, Arabic. Brothers and sisters, that's what you need to do, inshaAllah. You're very, I'm very, very impressed with you guys, mashallah, alhamdulillah. So far. This way. Come and stand close to me.
Yeah.
Like this, my friend.
Yeah. The proof that I'll be giving you that the Quran is the revelation of God is the memorization of the Quran.
Memorization.
Yeah. It is humanly impossible to memorize such a large quantity en masse. And wallahi, there are children 6 years old, seven
Sorry?
Years old.
What did you say?
There are children, wallahi, by God. There are children 6 years old, 7 years old, who have memorized the entire Quran. And it is amazing that these children...
How big is the Quran? What, 10 pages or 15 pages?
It is more than 6,000 verses.
How many words?
It is...
About 100,000. It's about 100,000. 100,000 words.
And it is amazing that these children, they... Can't even speak one paragraph correctly in their own mother tongue, yet they have memorized the entire book.
Oh, that's amazing.
And one more thing which cannot be said for any other book is that if all the Bibles and all the Hindu scriptures and all the Buddhist scriptures are thrown in the ocean, and if all those people of those religion agree that throw them all in the ocean, the Quran is the only religious scripture on the face of the earth, will be brought right back because it has been raised from cover to cover.
Excellent.
And this cannot be said for any other book.
MashaAllah.
So the Quran has to be.
I'm very impressed. MashaAllah. I'm ready to become Muslim now. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so I'm nearly. You have to tell me now a bit about Prophet Muhammad. So that's what we'll do next, inshallah. I really want to finish this section, inshallah, before we finish for today, because I have some homework for you guys.